Hello friends, so this time I am making the video in English language because earlier I was making Hindi videos but I was getting many dislikes due to the foreign audience. So this time for Hindi readers I am keeping the notes still in Hindi but the audio will be in English from this time. So let's try that. Okay. So this time we will be reading about the coloring of a graph. So what is a k-coloring of a graph? It is a mapping from the vertices of the graph BG to a set of natural numbers from 1 to k, that is 1, 2, 3 up till k. So each vertex is mapped to a color, to a number from 1 to k, let us say 2, 3, like that. So if a vertex is mapped to 2, that means it is being colored with C2, like that. So C2 is a color. So colors are C1, C2 up till. So these are like red, blue, green, and so on. Okay. And if we give each of the two neighbor vertices a different color, then we get a proper coloring. That is, if two vertices are neighbors, then we give them different color. Then we get a proper coloring. And if we are able to obtain a k-size proper coloring for a graph, then we call that graph a k-colorable graph. Okay. So, if to properly color a graph, we require k colors, at least k colors, then we call its chromatic number to be k, and it is represented by this symbol like x. This is some Greek letter, I think, zeta or something. Zeta g is equal to k. So this is our first notation in this coloring lecture. Okay. And one more fact, that if the chromatic number of a graph is k, but the chromatic number of all its proper subgraphs, which means the subgraphs except itself, you should know that a graph is always a subgraph of itself. So we exclude the graph itself and take all other subgraphs, and if all of the other subgraphs have a chromatic number less than k, where k is the chromatic number of this graph, then we call the graph G a color critical graph or k critical graph. Okay, let's come to the next notation, that is alpha G, which is called the independence number of G. So what is independence number? It is the size of largest independent set, and by size of largest independent set we mean the number of vertices in the largest independent set. So basically what is mean by independent set? The no two vertices are neighbors or they have an edge between them. In an independent set, so this is an independent set, no two vertices have an edge between them, so that is an independent set. Okay. The third and the final notation for us is omega g. So first one was zeta g, second was alpha g, then omega g. So what does omega g represent here? Omega g represents the largest complete subgraph of g's order. So basically what we mean by largest complete subgraph of G is the subgraph, the largest subgraph of G, which is a clique. So the subgraph which we are considering should be a clique, and it should be a subgraph of G. And what else? And we take its order, that is the number of vertices in G. So that we call omega g. Number of vertices in that subgraph. Okay. So basically, now we argue that zeta g can be greater than omega g. This is our argument number one. So we give a supporting example for that. We consider the graph g is equal to c of 2r plus 1 join ks, that is a cycle of 2r plus 1 vertices. That is basically 2r plus 1 is always an odd number, so basically this is an odd cycle we are considering. And another is a click, so let us consider a 4 click. So we consider s sized click in general, but here let us consider a 4 click. So basically, how we join them? We connect all of its vertices to this vertex, then all of its vertices to this vertex, then all of its vertices to this vertex, then all of its vertices to this vertex. That is, we join all of these vertices to all of these vertices. Okay. So to color an odd cycle, how many colors are required? 3 colors. How do we argue for that? Let us say this is colored by red, so this must be some another color. Let us say blue. Red, blue, this one, consider this one. We can't color it by red because this one is red. We can't color it with blue because this one is blue. So we must color it with a third color, let us say green. So this is green. So we require at least 3 colors for an odd cycle, coloring an odd cycle. For an even cycle, we require only 2 colors. You can see, if we color blue, red, it will work. Okay, but for an odd cycle, we require at least 3 colors to color it. And for an S-sized click, if we color this vertex by color number 1, then we must color this vertex by 2, this by 3, this by 4, because everything is connected here. If we color it by 1, there is no chance we can color any further vertex with 1. So each time we need to choose a new color. So for S times, we choose S more colors. Okay, so total S plus 3 colors are required. So zeta g is equal to S plus 3. So basically, and we see that omega g is equal to S plus 2. So let us get back to the definition of omega g. What does this notation represent? Okay, so omega g, okay, omega g is largest click subgraph of g. Okay, so this is of size s, and to get a click, all of the vertices must be connected. So this is joined by this, and this is joined by this also. So basically, a click will contain, largest click subgraph will contain whole of this one full, that is s vertices we have obtained till now, and these two vertices, any two adjacent vertices from the odd cycle. Why adjacent? Because if we take any other vertices than adjacent, then they are not joined, so they can't be a part of a click because they don't have an edge between them, which contradicts the definition of a click. So basically, we join this and this, we take these two vertices, and as these are all connected with these and connected among themselves also, so we get a S plus 2 size click at max. So it is a, what is omega g? The largest click's order. So largest click's order is S plus 2. Omega g is equal to S plus 2, and zeta g is equal to S plus 3. So we have shown for our example that xg is, zeta g is greater than omega g, That is, we have proved that zeta g can be greater than omega g, which was required. Thank you, friends.